Hey guys, welcome to Surfing Show. I'm Noel Salas, and today's surfboard review is on the Air 17X by JS Surfboards. I'm super excited to talk about this board. It's a small wave performance board, fits the criteria of where I surf on a regular basis. This is gonna be a fun review, so sit back, grab your favorite drink, and enjoy the show. Now, the Air 17X is a modified Air 17, which was originally created as a pro model for Julian Wilson for a little bit smaller waves, but still have that progressive feel and surf to it. It's got a little bit flatter rocker here in the belly, a little more added foam under the front foot, so it's gonna be a little bit more speed down the line. And the Air 17 was an exaggerated or increase in single to double concave, and when we add that kind of single concave, it's gonna give more lift and more speed. Now, if you look at the outline of the Air 17X, it's much like the Air 17. Now, I never had the privilege of riding the Air 17, but what I think is really important is to capture the outline looks like a high-performance shortboard. Now, a lot of these guys on tour, like Julian, or even some of the guys in the QS, they want that extra speed and performance in small waves, but they need the outline to look like a high-performance shortboard, so that way it's appealing to the judge's eyes. Now, for me, the rocker and the way this board's designed really suits point breaks in my type of surfing. But because it has an aggressive, medium to aggressive tail rocker and entry rocker, it still feels like it fits in the pocket real good, and it has great traction off the bottom. So I mentioned rocker and concave. Another thing I want to talk about is the rail. Now the rail is, I wouldn't say it's full, I would say it's soft. Right, there is some foam up in here, but the wide point on this board is pretty dead center. Like I said, it really looks like a high performance shortboard, maybe a little bit shorter, a little bit wider, and a tad thicker, right? And as we go back in here to the rail, it doesn't start getting sharp till back here by the side fins, which I also like because I find it to be very forgiving, especially when we took it out and I'm riding it in like 2 to 3 foot choppy, bumpy surf. Right, I still felt like it had that great projection. It did have that get up and go speed that the JS website talks about on this design. I pop up and we get going, and right away I can put it on rail and I can connect every section with speed and flow all the way till the end. Now there's another reason I think that it has great flow and speed is the tail block here has a decent amount of surface area. So when we couple that with an aggressive single to double, that's when we get the lift and the speed we're looking for in small waves. So on the Air 17X, I really noticed that it had great traction and felt like a high performance shortboard. But since it's flatter in the rocker through here, that's what I've been talking about, where it has that extra get up and go speed, as opposed to a board that has more curve or rocker throughout, so it'd be a little bit more continuous, that would need a wave that had maybe more curve in it or bigger, where you'd want to actually be able to get that speed and actually even be able to push harder or have more traction on the bottom. But for me, on the waves that we got, I really felt like we had great waves for this review, and I really felt like this board performed well, whether it was 2 to 3 foot chop or it, when it got a little bit bigger overhead on the sets, I got waves that I had to get a lot of speed to get around sections, and then I had the confidence that I wanted to lay into those turns and have the traction I was looking for. Now, we were just looking at the Air 17X curvature. This is a Monsta 8. Now, it's waxed and ready, but I haven't ridden it yet because I'm waiting for the correct wave size and curve. And I find that high-performance shortboards like the Monsta 8 and where I surf, I don't ride them as often as I'd like. Where I surf, it's kind of slopey, so it doesn't get super steep. It has steep sections where you can get up and smash it. But these types of boards, for me, they have more curve overall rocker, so they're not going to be as fast, but it's going to have better traction, right? And I always talk about that. Now, I surf with the pros out at where I surf on a regular basis all the time, and they kind of go back and forth. It doesn't matter who I'm surfing with. They go back and forth with riding high performance short boards with more curve, or they ride boards that have a little less curve in the belly so they can maximize speed. But one of the things I wanted to mention about the Monster 8 and boards like this is when you have that continuous rocker, they feel really loose under your feet, maybe a little bit looser than something with the flatter rocker in the belly. And like I said, it's got that incredible traction. I'm always looking for maximum drive, and I think that's why the Air 17X fits a daily driver like for me on a regular basis, because I'm riding that 2 to 4, 2 to 5 foot surf 95% of the time. Now I want to talk about the fins I chose. I've been doing a lot of testing. I really like the AM2 fins in smaller waves and in bigger waves, but this is a new prototype fin that Futures is coming out with called the Beta Series. Now this is a speed generating fin, and what makes this fin unique is it's a new construction that they're calling Vapor Core Series. It's a full carbon layup, so it's super, super light. And I mentioned it's speed generating, and what makes this fin a little bit different besides the construction from like the Black 6 or the Generation is it's the only speed generating fin that doesn't have the V2 foil. This has a flat foil. Now, I like the V2 foil, and in the Black 6, they have the AM1s, which is the medium merit template. And I don't ride those because I like a large fin for maximizing speed in small waves. So if I'm gonna get that flex and pop, I wanna step into a larger fin. And this is the first speed generating fin that they've done with the merit template in the AM2s. I tested these in 1 to 3. I wanted to go to overhead and see how they would hold in. Now with this board being a PU construction, I was hoping to get a little bit more spring and pop out of my turns with these fins, and I felt like it gave that to me. But let's look closely at the fin. We got a wide fin base for extra drive. It was there for me. And then we had we got more sweep. This probably has more rake than any fins I've tested so far. And what am I gonna get with that rake? It's gonna draw the turns. I'm gonna be able to lay into the carves, but I've mentioned in the past that every board has a shaper's dot, and that's where the shaper recommends the back of the side fins to be placed. Now, anything, if we were to draw an imaginary line past the back edge of the leading edge of the back fin right here, anything that the fin goes past that shaper's dot, that's also gonna increase speed. I really enjoyed these fins, and I feel like these are probably my favorite in the Futures lineup for speed generating. Look, Futures is doing a prototype testing stage. You can go on their website, you can purchase these fins and join all of us, and you can be one of those test pilots too. So let's look at some waves together. Really nice wave here, overhead, lots of speed, hit that turn with a ton of confidence, able to go right into the bottom turn, quick little turn there, but just setting up a little speed projection floater, hoping to keep going. Now here backside, wave's a little flat right there, able to put it on bottom turn, right into the top turn, and another one to finish it, it felt great. Now here, quick turn, nice little check turn, coming into another turn right there, watch the wave take off, board's got the speed I'm looking for, tail gets a little free, that's what I like these fins with that narrow tip, just felt good in general. Now this wave coming off the bottom, waiting for it to set up. Here it goes right here. What I liked about this board, I got up here late. Sometimes I fall doing that, but the board was under my feet. It felt great. Here on this little backside left, two good turns. Watch the wave kind of slow down. The board, it gets a little steeper. The board takes off and able to finish this wave really, really strong. Now I thought we'd look at some smaller waves together. This wave still has decent size, but watch this quick little turn right here. That's the pop of the fins I'm looking for. Now here the wave goes a little bit flat, so I'm kind of waiting for it to set up. And as it starts to go, this quick turn, little check turn right here, because I want to pop a little air. And it just felt like, almost like I'm driving a sports car. Really responsive. Watch this turn on this left right here, pop. That's what I'm looking for when the waves are small. Now we're surfing some smaller, junky, windy waves. Watch the board start to go. That turn was good, and then able to spin it real quick. So the board felt good, even in these choppy waves. Here's that one I was talking about, more like a QS, good flow here. Just the wave just kept going, and the board kept projecting and getting me into the right spot. So now I want to talk about the construction. We always look at whether it's PU or EPS. We kind of put a scale 1 to 10 on durability with pressure dents. 10 meaning no pressure dents at all. I would say this is coming in at about a 6.5, 7, which is pretty high for a PU. Now this board was made in Australia, and I don't know what they're doing, if the foam's different, but the durability is great. And I also felt like the glass job, the board was super light, and I got that performance, so I felt like I got the pop I wanted out of each turn. Now, if they made the Air 17X in the Hi-Fi construction, which I'm a huge fan of, I really liked it on the Monster Box, I think it would increase paddling, flex and pop in and out of turns, and it would give a greater amount of flex in the lifespan of the board also. So well done on construction as a PU, and I really enjoyed it. So the last thing I want to mention is the traction I chose. This is the FCS Julian Wilson pad. Now I'm talking about traction because our community has been asking me to do so. I really like this pad for a couple reasons. It's got a high tail kick and a super high arch bar. And I have a big arch in my foot, and this suits me real well. Now I know pads are a preference because some people have flat feet or we just like what we like. This pad, because of the high arch, is one of my favorites right now. Now, one of the things that I also prefer is a softer pad. This pad's got a lot of traction, it's abrasive, it's a little bit rougher. So if it was a little bit softer, it would be hands down my favorite pad. But some people like a little bit more abrasive because it is really tacky and it has great traction. Now look, I like the Air 17X. It was a great board. I think it fits that 2 to 6 foot surf. I recommend it for guys that are on the higher end of the intermediate to advanced surfers because it's so performance driven and it's very, very sensitive to giving you what you want as a surfer. Now, I'm excited to ride the Monster 8. This board's waxed and ready, so be watching out for that review. Hey, and if you like the show, subscribe. Tell your friends. You can also find us at surfandshow.com or Instagram under surfandshow. That's it for today. Special shout out thanks to JS for sending these boards down for review. Until next time, see you in the water. Bye-bye. Let's see.